a call for an uprising. We welcome you to today's show and ask those of you who have not subscribed, please subscribe to our YouTube channel as we continue to expose the satanic Illuminati agenda and the ushering in of the Antichrist. Another day, another music video, more satanic Illuminati symbols. Just every single day these videos come out from these mainstream stars. Today it's French Montana featuring Drake. I've talked about Drake on this channel. Drake, somebody who started off as a child actor, who then, you know, they betrays this. Oh, he's lived on the streets, he's had this rough life, he'll fall for this stuff. This guy's had a silver spoon in his mouth since birth. And if you're wondering how our society, as I constantly talk about on this channel, how our society has become so dumbed down, how our society is just zombies walking around, which everybody who listens to this channel is aware. We see these people walking around, walking into walls on their cell phones, unaware of what's going on, not questioning anything, going along with all of these agendas that the elitists want. Look no further than the music that these people listen to. Look no further, because this is what they get pushed into their head. You know, it sits there in their unconscious mind, their subconscious. They don't even know what's going on. But listen to some of the lyrics from this song. Sipping on the drink, sipping on the drink. Over and over, sipping on the drink, sipping on the drink. All about the moolah, all about the moolah. Word to the bird, I ain't never take her for shopping. I mean, okay. Anyone want to translate that? No idea. But the entire video, in addition to the Illuminati symbols, which I'll show you, which they continue to condition the masses with, you know, they're sitting by a pool, everybody's drunk, women are just in thongs. This is completely, you know, just completely disgusting. But what they do is these musicians try to make this look like this is the life that all of these teenagers try to achieve, which they can't achieve unless, you know, they inherit money somehow, or they rob a bank, or of course, unless they become an elitist. Otherwise, you'll be a slave to the system like everyone else. But they want you to strive and try to have this life so that you can waste it away, trying to be drunk all the time, going to these parties, having a great time. This is how people don't ever grow up. You have 30-year-olds still acting like this, 40-year-old men still acting like this, all part of the brainwashing and the conditioning. So you have the party scene, everybody's drunk. You know, they want you to strive for the moolah, strive for the drank, as the guy says in the song. It's a complete joke. French Montana is a part of this satanic system. He has affiliations and tie-ins with the Kardashian family. Drake obviously has been a part of this for quite some time. And if you read deeper, you'll see that Drake is actually homosexual and a sex slave for a lot of these elitists. But of course, he plays the role of this hard thug guy. And everybody thinks that he's, oh, he's on edge and all that. I mean, it's just, it's a complete illusion. And all the kids out there fall for this stuff and look up to these guys. Drake always flashing the 666. So let's start with some of the symbols we see. We see the 666 flashed right in front of our faces over and over. Drake showing the 666, as you can see. We see the devil horns repeatedly used in this video. We see French Montana throwing up devil horns. We see Drake throwing up devil horns. What people don't realize is that this is how they condition people not only to use these symbols, these, you know, satanic symbols themselves in their day-to-day life. People see it and they go, oh, it means rock and roll. Oh, it means this. Oh, it means Diablo, but it's not paying worship to Satan. Of course it's paying worship to him. It's his symbol. The 666 and the devil horns. You see that over and over. I guess that's a coincidence, right? Just another music video where these people are flashing these symbols. I'm supposed to believe it's a coincidence, of course. All of us are, because they think we're so stupid. But in reality, unfortunately, the people who listen to this music are the ones who don't have a functioning brain inside their heads. And they see this stuff and they, oh, okay, it's just a coincidence that he keeps throwing up this hand symbol. Because we all do that, right? You go out in your yard, you mow the lawn, you're throwing up these hand symbols. You go somewhere, you go to Target, you go to Walmart to pick up some you know, deodorant or something like that. Are you throwing up these hand symbols? People are doing it all the time, right? Of course not. But in these music videos, they throw these symbols up all the time. And we're supposed to believe what? Oh, he's throwing up gang symbols. Oh, he's paying homage to, that's what they say, Drake's paying homage to where he grew up. I mean, give me a break that people buy into this stuff. This is conditioning of the masses with these satanic hand symbols. Then, of course, you see Drake's shirt. I talked about it on this channel before with the owls. And there's a guy in the background, he's the owl. Now, I understand that Drake apparently, but this is how they do stuff, right? I always talk about this. They always try to cover their tracks and cover their symbols. So he has this thing called October's Very Own. It's supposed to be, the owl represents October's Very Own. And you see Johnny Manziel has been involved with it before. He did a video on that. And we're supposed to believe it stands for people whose birthdays are in October. So Drake went to all this effort to create this owl, to create this you know, this marketing thing that he's doing, because it's about his birthday. It's about people born in October. It's a complete joke. We all know what goes on in October. We know about Halloween and the days leading sacrifices that are committed in that month. But let's be realistic. The owl represents knowledge. It represents being illuminated to the elitist. We see the owl where? Well, we see the owl represented at Bohemian Grove. We see the giant statue of the owl that they perform the cremation of hair in front of. It must be a coincidence. So he just picked the owl because Drake apparently is knowledgeable. It's a paying homage to the elitist, the Illuminati, because the owl represents knowledge. The owl represents Minerva, the goddess of wisdom. The Enlightened see themselves as the wise rulers of the planet. I always talk about how the Illuminati view themselves as how the elitists view themselves. That is to rule over us, that they're wiser than we are. They contain and control all the knowledge because they've dumbed down the rest of the world. But we have the knowledge because the only knowledge that matters is that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. That's all the knowledge that I need. But you'll see the owl featured at Bohemian Grove. They have the sign that says, "Weaving spiders, come not here." You know, interpreting that people who are going to weave and deceive don't come into Bohemian Grove because it's a secret society and a brotherhood. We see the owl tattoo all over the place. You know, musicians have the owl tattoo. Justin Bieber has it. Like I said, Johnny Manziel, the football player, has it. A lot of them have it. Okay, it doesn't represent October's very, you know, it doesn't represent people born in October and their birthday. You even see the owl hidden on the dollar bill in the corner. So the owl has a lot of satanic symbolism to the occult. The owl, like I said, represents their knowledge, the knowledge that they think that they have over us, and that they're the illuminated ones, and we are just cattle to them. So like I said, Drake is wearing a shirt covered in owls. You'll see a guy in the background wearing an owl on his shirt. Then, of course, we see Drake pay homage to the Freemasons, because this is what it's all about for them. The Freemasons, he makes the hand across the neck. It is a sign of sacrifice. It's a symbol that the hand placed in the neck signifies sacrifice. Sacrifice can have two meanings, of course. One, the continuing threat of the penalties to be applied to punish those people, those initiates, who reveal the secrets of the order, and two, the willingness of the individual performing the sign to sacrifice himself for the good of the order, or for the good of the cause, or great work of the elitists, of the Freemasonry, of the Illuminati. Okay, you also see the neck ritual, which can be linked to Duncan's Masonic ritual, and it can be linked to disobedience of members of the secret society. Who are disobedient will have their neck cut from their head in the ritual for the Grand Master Elect degree. According to Richardson's Monitor of Freemasonry, the candidate either places the point of a knife under the chin or alternately clenching the fingers of the right hand, extending the thumb, placing it on the abdomen, and moving it upwards to the chin as if ripping the body open with a knife. That is what that symbol means. I'm sure people out there have seen it and they think it means something that's not related to Freemasonry. That's where the symbol comes from, where people put their finger across their neck. It's a Masonic hand gesture. That's where it originates from. So when you see a video like this where they're just standing out by the pool the entire time and they're just throwing up hand gestures, they don't go anywhere, they don't leave the poolside area, just everybody's drunk. This is exactly how they work. This is how they operate. They don't need to show you pyramids. They don't need to show you hidden things. They're showing you the symbols right in front of you. Because people are staring at Drake's eyes, staring at his face as he mesmerizes them with his witchcraft music, and they're not looking at his hands, seeing why is he flashing all these signs. And people out there go, oh, they're just gang signs. He's a member of a gang. He's throwing up gang signs. Yeah, he is a member of a gang. It's a secret society that run the world. He's a member of that. And he works and operates for them. So you see him throwing up the 666, the devil horns. You see, of course, you know, there's other agendas in these videos. This is the lifestyle that they want people to thrive, to live for. They want everybody to be, you know, living their lives thinking about, oh, how can I become rich? How can I become famous? Because they know it's a dead end. They know it's a dead end. They know that these people are going to be dependent on the system because they're going to grow up their whole lives wanting to be a musician, not realizing you can't be one. You can't crack through unless you're a member of these secret societies. They control what's a trend. They control what music people like or don't like. If this music, French Montana's music, was out 100 years ago, he'd be burned at the stake, okay? They dictate what music people like and what they don't like. This is all part of mind control. They play it over and over again on the radio. They beat it into your head, and people start to like it. Then they start to feel like, okay, well, you know, French Montana and Drake, they start to dress like them. They start to act like them. That's how mind control works. That is what they're doing here. So they're showing you this lifestyle that they want people, they want teenagers to try to strive for. They want you to be drunk. They want you to party. They want you to be out by the pool all night with women in thongs. They're supposed to make it look like it's a great time. I couldn't even imagine how this looks like a great time. I'd rather get a root canal than be at this party. Look at these people just dancing up and down, jumping in the pool, chugging champagne, singing songs that just go, drink and drink, let's have a drink, let's drink, 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 drunk, drink, drink, moolah, 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 moolah. And people just sing it, they eat it up, they go, oh, what a great track, what an artistic track. Yeah, it's real artistic, drink, drink, moolah, moolah, over and over again, talking about ridiculous things, dumbing down entire society. And that's the goal of these music videos. They dumb down society with this music because people start to relate to the musicians. They look up to them. They admire them. They don't realize that these people are part of a secret society, that these people have sold their souls, that these people aren't what they look like. They aren't these hard-edged thug guys. And they're not. They're not at all. But this is what they've created society. This is what they've done. They've created this society that worships this lifestyle and wants this lifestyle. So while you look for Illuminati symbols and all this stuff in music videos, and we see them here, blatantly obvious, we see them in Kanye West's video, we see them in Beyonce, we see them over and over. Videos like this, this is how they brainwash and dumb down the masses. This is exactly how they do it. They want you to strive for this lifestyle, to live like this, to live this disgusting, you know, self-absorbed life that's all about money. And then they create this illusion that your whole life is about, you know, you and achieving money and buying things, this materialistic lifestyle, all things that God does not want people to do. These people never satisfy their souls. They always live a life with an empty soul because they don't have the Holy Spirit with them. They don't have God with them. That's why nothing is never enough for these people out there who live lives like this. It's never enough because they can never find gratification because they don't have God in their lives. And the sad part about it is that people out there are influenced by this, and they look up and admire these people. And they think that this is really how they live, and they think that this is, you know, oh, they earned this, you know, oh, they grew up poor, and then they went out and they earned it, they worked their way to it, and everybody buys into it. It's the same story, you hear it all the time. It's like the Rocky Balboa story, right? Rags to riches, oh, on the streets, but you can do it, you can work hard, you can achieve it, and you can be like Drake. If you want to, you know, commit human sacrifice and sell your soul, sure, you can achieve something, but probably not even to the level Drake's at, but you can achieve something if you, you know, if they allow you to be initiated in it, and you're ready to sacrifice, and then you're ready to be, you know, called upon by them whenever they want, for you to do whatever ritual they want, whether it's give your body up to them sexually, like these musicians do, because the majority of them are sex slaves to the elitists, and that's a fact, where they call upon you to sacrifice a family member to be a part of it. That's how this whole thing works. But again, it's huge mind control. It's a huge psyop on everybody out there who listens to this stuff and falls for it. The symbols are there, as always, to continue to indoctrinate the masses with these symbols, to condition them with these symbols, that we're going to see over and over and over, symbols that represent Satan, that represent them paying homage to their master, Satan. So don't fall for this stuff. If somebody just jumped onto this channel because you wanted to see a new Illuminati video about Drake or French Montana, because you saw the video, might have seen the sign, understand this. You're a pawn in their game. We all are pawns in their game. If you follow this music and you look up to these people, you're falling into the trap, okay? You're getting led to hell by falling into the trap, because that's what these people are here to do. That's their job. So don't fall for it. Remember that Jesus Christ is the only way to our Father. He is the life. Okay? He is the truth, the only truth in this world. Always remember that. And thank you for listening to today's show. God bless all of you and your families.